Let's take a very, very fast look at stories in the entertainment scene. Of course, Afrima 2019, now Nigerian music icon Mr. Innocent Idibia, popularly known as Tubaba, alongside Grammy nominee Burna Boy, emerged major winners at the 6th All Africa Music Awards. Now, other Nigerian artists who bagged an award or two that night include Wizkid, Tiwa Savage, Joe Boy, and DJ Spinall. The 2019 Afrima Legendary Award was given to Nigerian Afropop idol Tubaba and then Congolese music icon Awilologumba, while Burna Boy's African Giant won the album of the year. He also won the best male artist in Western Africa for his song Ye. Similarly, Wizkid's song Fever won the song of the year, while Tiwa Savage won the best female artist in Western Africa for her song One. So now, the thing about this award, it's a very, very Nigerian award.
Oh, yeah. No, but there were some categories that were not won by Nigerians.
Yes, I know, but like Afrima has always, like, I've always, you know, majorly, the Nigerians, and we're doing quite well when it comes to Nigerian scene.
I
mean, when you look at how much of, when you look at Beyonce's album and how many Nigerians were featured.
Yes.
So I think we're doing quite well in the music scene.
I think another reason why it seems like it's a Nigerian award is because no shades to other countries.
Okay.
But in the international level, I think a lot of Nigerian artists are really pushing to be in the international music world. So that's why it looks like we had once dominating the Afrima.
All right, great one. Now moving on from that.
So Davido's A Good Time sets a new record. Davido has, this is his second album, and he's become the first Nigerian album to reach number one on the US pop iTunes chart and top 10 on general iTunes chart. Now this feat by the album is a record setting one, as it is the first time a Nigerian album would sit at number one on the US album pop chart on iTunes and also enter into the top 10 US album chart on the same platform. Mm. The album has only been released, and to be able to command such positions on the US iTunes is a fantastic achievement.
It is. Two of the songs that stand out for me are 1 Milli and of course Anima Shaun. A number of people also like quite a number of songs. Of course, you have
Risky's
there. You have Blow My Mind with Chris Brown.
Yeah.
Some few singles, about four or five of singles that were ahead of what Davido that had blown before now.
Yes.
Are also part of the album. And you know, something about the album is a very emotional one for him.
He
dedicates the album to his mom, also to DJ Olu.
Yes.
He had a picture and all of that. So it's a big one for Davido personally.
The graphic image that was released. Tells a lot about where he is mentally. And I think because Davido is quite, he's relatable, and you can see him trying to connect with his audience, connect with his fans, and bring people around him in. So I think it's actually something that we should celebrate.
Great one. And then moving on from that, Mr. Easy calls out Hip TV on Twitter. Now, he took a dig at Hip TV over their failure to give him the card that came with the next rated award he won at the 2016 Headies. Now, however, 3 years after, Mr. Easy, who took a swipe at them after they shared a photo of him and his girlfriend, Temi Otedola. Now, the thing about this, I spoke with OG, of course, one of our reporters and presenters on eSplash, and he reached out to Mr. Easy's management.
Okay.
So this was what happened, because the car was given to Mr. Easy.
Oh, it was given?
It was given to him.
Okay.
But the organizers from reports, they reportedly got the car on a loan from a bank.
Oh,
so
wow.
What actually happened was that the bank repossessed the car when the loan was not paid.
Oh, wow.
So that's the issue. So because a lot of people were seeing him with the car.
Oh,
you know,
we're
seeing him even driving around with the car and all of that. So that's the issue now. The car was repossessed by the bank, and so he actually does not have a car now. And I think that's something that the organizer should
probably look into that, because I'm sure this year's winner got the car. So they definitely should look to give him back his car.
Yeah, they should. Okay. All right.
So moving on, Burna Boy's African Giant nominated for a Grammy. It is no longer news that Nigeria's Burna Boy has been nominated in the Best World Music Album category for African Giant in the 2020 Grammy Awards, with Beyoncé's The Lion King, The Gift, contesting for the Best Pop Vocal Album. He has two shots at his first Grammy Award. Now, do you think Burna Boy would bring home this award?
Oh, wow, Omoe, that's a strong team. That's a strong
team. I think being nominated alone
is big.
It's big. I'm not saying I don't want him to win.
But just putting it on your CV that you're nominated. I agree with you. The big one also, you know, still talking about the Grammys, Trevor Noah, that's also a big one for Africa. Big
Trevor
one for
Noah,
myself.
Yes.
You know, now, The Daily Show host Trevor Noah, of course, continues his global ascent into comedy's upper echelon with Son of Patricia sprawling out from the temporal confines of his hosting show. Now, the South African comedian dazzles on his way to his first career Grammy nomination. He was nominated alongside big names like comedian turned television superstar Ellen DeGeneres, Jim Gaffigan, the Spike Jones, and of course, the one and only Dave Chappelle, who is his mentor. You know, that's Sticks and Stones was nominated, as well as Son of Patricia. I've listened to Sticks and Stones very well. Listened to Son of Patricia. I'm not done with
you're
it.
You're not done yet.
This is big. This is big for Trevor Noah. And I think that this is something that it tells of how much work this guy has put into his art. What do you think about Trevor Noah and what he's doing for Africa globally?
I think Trevor Noah is doing a lot for Africa globally, and I think it's really encouraging for all young comedians to see that you can do it whatever you put your mind to.
Exactly.
And you could even get recognized at the international level for whatever it is.
Dino Melaye is into Nollywood. Man, he has always been done a little. I don't know why I'm saying he's finally entering the level. But his official film, his first cinema, of course, movie role in a new Nollywood blockbuster titled Lemonade. Now it's set to premiere December 11th at the Transcorp Hilton in Abuja. Now the senator, who had had a taste of acting in a new TV series, Equity Unbound, features alongside the stellar cast, there's Kule Remy, there's Joy Idoko, there's Ayola, Ayobami, quite a number of them and all of that. So he has already been an actor for me. Dino Melaye has been an actor for me. So this one is the official cinema appearance for him, right?
It is official.
I mean, considering that he lost the election, shouldn't he just go into Nollywood?
Come on, he still has his political career, but going into Nollywood was interesting, I must say.
He should. All right, okay, that's all we have to do on entertainment.